What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about massing in Revit and just kind of a quick interesting project. I'm going to be showing you how to model this building in Revit. So we have some interesting slanted walls, and then also we have a kind of a wavy roof, so to speak. So I just wanted to kind of take a look at how something like this can be modeled in Revit, and just to show you kind of the whole approach. It can seem very difficult at first, but when you learn how to use all of the tools and also how to use them properly, you'll see that it's actually fairly simple and straightforward. Now, if you want to learn more about massing in Revit and just kind of advanced modeling, well, I have a course for that. So I'm going to leave a link just below this video in the description below or up in the cards above. I have this whole video on advanced modeling inside of the massing environment in Revit. It kind of takes you through all of the tips, tricks, workflows. We have different projects. It's quite interesting, and it kind of covers pretty much everything you need to know about mass modeling inside of Revit. So if you want to kind of take it to the next level, be sure to check that out. Now, also, before we get started with the video, I would just like to ask you to like this video and also make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell icon. Not only does it help you not miss any of the future videos on my channel, but also it does make the alpaca happy. And let's be honest, that's why we're all here. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump into Revit and then let's start modeling this. So here I'm just going to go to models and then start a new project. So let's go here to new. For the template file, I'm going to be using my personal architecture design template, the metric version. Now, if you're interested in checking out my templates, you can find them also on my website, balkanarchitect.com. It's going to be, just as I said, just below this video and up in the cards above. There you can find all of my templates, but also quite recently I have added some really high quality Revit families, really highly detailed and parametric, and also we have a really interesting plugin as well. So just make sure to check that out if you're interested in something like that. Okay, so now let's choose the template, click OK, and let's let Revit start right up. So as soon as Revit starts up, I'm going to kind of move away from the starting view. Let's go to the site plan. You know, we're going to be working here a lot. And then also, let's just go to elevations, open up perhaps the south elevation, and just adjust the levels a little bit. So level 2 is at 360, which is kind of all right for, I don't know, like office buildings or residential architecture. But for something like this, I think we need a bit of a higher ceiling. This is more of a showroom type building. So let's go here to 600 centimeters, or perhaps 550, not to go too crazy. Okay, so once we have something that looks like this, the next step is to start modeling the massing. So for that, I'm going to go back here to the site plan, go to massing and site, and the first thing you want to do here is go to show mass and turn that on. This will, well, make sure that you can actually see the mass that you're modeling. The next step is obviously to go to in place mass, click on that, you can name it here, I'm just going to click OK. And now we can get started. So for this mass, I'm just going to go to the rectangle tool. You want to set the placement plane on level 1 and then just create a simple rectangle. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now we can adapt this. Now, once you hover over it, it's going to try to select the whole thing. So if you just hit the tab key once, you can only kind of select one of these lines, and then you can adjust the size. So here for the width, I'm going to go with something like 1200 centimeters, and then for the length, so again by using the tab key, perhaps something like 2000 centimeters. There we go. Okay, so we have a rectangle, looks fairly okay. Let's move to the 3D view, just like this, and then I'm just going to select it, go to create form, and then you just click here on create form, and this is what you get. Now, as you can see, it kind of shot a little bit past that level 2. And I'm actually fine with that. I'm just going to leave it as is. Okay, moving forward, we want to get that kind of tapering of the walls. So what I'm going to do is select this inner wall, and then, for example, you can use this dimension to, well, add a number. So for example, if I want to move it in by 100 centimeters, I would just turn this into 1100, click OK, and then it's going to come in like this, see? Or perhaps 150, so then I would say here 050. There we go. And then I can say, okay, that looks fairly cool. So now I can do the same thing on the other side. So you just make sure you select the line only. So not the panels and not the whole thing, but the line only. And you can use the tab key if that helps you out. So anyways, here, let's see, do we get any dimensions? So unfortunately we don't. So let's just move this one. So I'm just going to move it in. Let's see. Okay, the work plane is kind of odd here. So when you get something like this, this is really annoying. This can happen sometimes. So I just like to go to set work plane and then just set it back to level 1, then select this plane again. Let's see, can we move this now? There we go. So that was 150. Let's type in 150. Move it in. Okay, kind of moved it off to the side. So working with massing can be really difficult in some cases. So let's try that again. Let's move. There we go. 150. Okay, now it almost seems all right. So let's... it tends to warp that a little bit. So if you don't want that, perhaps the best case scenario is then just try to move it and try to get it as equal as possible. There we go, that seems to look fine. You can also use reference planes to measure. So for example, if I go here to, let's see, let's go to south elevation, or no, that one was west elevation, I think. Yeah, you can go here to west elevation, and then you can go reference plane and give it an offset, 150. And just go like that, see? And then you can use that reference plane here. If I go back to the 3D view, select this line, go back here to west elevation, and there we go. So now you can kind of make sure it goes up to that reference plane. So this is one of those things when it comes to massing, it can be sometimes really difficult to adjust it correctly, but you have to kind of find a workaround how to do it. So here, let's go again, 150, so that's, I think, 1850. There we go, do the same thing on the other side. But again, we have the same problem, so let's just move it in like this. I'm going to eyeball it for this one. I don't have to be too precise. Okay, so the next step is to create that wavy roof. So for the roof, what you want to do, or what I like to do, is go to the site plan, and then let's use this reference plane, for example, and just kind of outline where that roof is going to be. So I'm just going to extend this a little bit, and let's use a dimension line, perhaps like this. There we go, let's measure, and let's say I want it to be 400, kind of 400 centimeters away from the building. That's where I want kind of the roof edge to be. Let's go to reference plane again. We can use, again, an offset of 400. Perhaps go like this. Flip it to the other side by using the space key. Perfect. So we have that. And then let's just repeat that. So again, offset 400. Perfect. And finally, just do one more below. So reference plane, line, offset 400. There we go. Okay, so once you have this in place, what you want to do next is you want to name the kind of the top and the bottom reference planes. So this one I'm going to name number 1, hit enter. This one I'm going to name number 2, and then hit enter. So once I have this, I can then move down to the south elevation and I can create the curves here. So what I'm going to do is go to model lines, pick a plane, and then let's pick reference plane number one, click OK. And then you can just use a simple spline like this, and then I'm just going to create that wavy shape, just like that. Go back to modify. Okay, I kind of shot past this. So just hit the tab key to select just the endpoint, like that. Perfect, and then you can kind of readjust it a little bit. Perhaps like this. I think this looks okay. So I'm let's say I'm happy with the way that this turned out. Okay, I have to move this in a bit. Perfect. Okay, so I have one of these. So let's do the second one now. So what I'm going to do for that one is just select this one, go to copy, and then perhaps in 3D view it's going to make more sense. So here in 3D view, you go to paste, you go to aligned to the same place. So it's just going to duplicate that one, and then the second one is going to be selected. So then you simply go here to host and change it to reference plane number two. So it's just going to kind of copy it to the other side. And then what you can do is go back to the south elevation. It's still selected. So you just go here to the mirror tool, perhaps pick access, uncheck copy, and then you just mirror it. Okay, I accidentally selected this line. I wanted the level, but that's okay. Doesn't make too much of an issue. So now I can just rotate this a little bit. Okay, that might have been a bit too much. Let's go back. Let's go from here to something like that. Okay, this is starting to look okay. Okay, so once you're happy with those two lines, now it's time to connect those. But actually, before you connect those, you want to copy them. So let me show you. So just select one, hold the control key, select the second one, and then you want to go here to copy, paste, align to the same place. So I've duplicated both of them. And the reason why I did that is because I actually need two planes. One is going to be a part of a void that's going to be cutting the top of this this shape here, or the building. And then the second one is going to be actually hosting the roof. So let me show you. Let's do the void first. So you just go to the line tool, for example. You go to draw on work plane. You set it on, let's say, reference plane number one. So that's this one here. And then you just go up like this. I don't know. Yeah, we can go like that. Go up to the second one, and then you just connect it to the second one. There we go. And then on the other side, you just go reference plane number two, and then you repeat that same shape. Doesn't have to be perfectly kind of same, but it kind of just has to look similar. There we go. So once we have these two, now we can select the whole chain like this, hold the control key, select the chain here, go to create form, expand that, and go to void form. And as you can see, it's just going to create a void that's cutting that roof and giving it that curvature. Now we still have these two left, so that's why we've duplicated those. And now these we can just go to create form, just regular solid form, and it's going to create a plane for that roof. So see why you have to sometimes duplicate things, because you need one to do one thing, and then you need the second one to do the second thing. Okay, so once we're done with this, I can simply finish this mass. And now it's as simple as just kind of completing the walls here and the roof. So for that, you go to masking and sight, you go to curtain system, and here you have this one. Now this one seems to have these panels which are wider than they are tall, which doesn't make too much sense for me. So I just go here to edit type, I duplicate, and I just reverse this, or I change it a little bit. So for example here, we can go with something like, yeah, we can go with 3000 by 1500 millimeters. Click OK. And then you just flip these. So this one is going to be 150 and this one is going to be 300. Click OK. Now, once you have done that, you select multiple surfaces. So this one, and this one. You go create system. And as you can see, now we have that curtain system on the bottom. And then on top, usually you're going to have a different system on top. So what you want to do with that one is again, curtain system, edit type, duplicate. This one is just going to be square, 2x2. So 2000 by 2000. click OK, and then this is going to be 200 by 200, click OK, and then we can just kind of click there, create system, and it's going to look like that. And obviously now you just want to assign some mullions to this. So for that, go to architecture, go to curtain system, and then you can assign mullions, and also you can assign different panels. So you can just kind of select those curtain systems, go here into edit type. Here, as you can see, the curtain panel was not defined, so you can just set that to solid, click apply. Okay, now as you can see, it looks like it's made out of glass, or not solid. Yeah, why did they do solid? Yeah, let's do glazed. Apply. Okay. And then on top, for example, you can do solid. So you can go here, edit type, and then define this one as solid. Yeah, that makes more sense. And also you can add mullions, of course. So you just go here to mullion, go all grids, and then you just kind of make sure you click the whole thing. And you can do the same thing on top here, and it's just going to generate that, those mullions and so on. And finally, if you want to create perhaps some columns that are holding this thing together, you can do that as well. So for example, if I go here to the site plan, and in the site plan I just like to go to here to wireframe, and then once we're here in wireframe, I just like to kind of gauge where the columns would go. So for example, let's say that we want columns to go from the center of this square all the way up to these two spots. So for something like that, what I would do is, or perhaps from here to here, that makes a bit more sense. Yeah, let's follow that. So what I would do for that is either use reference planes or grids. I prefer reference planes, so just kind of try to follow the center. It doesn't have to be perfect. So just like this, and then one here. There we go. So this one is going to be reference plane A. This one's going to be reference plane B. There we go. And then finally, you just need a section. So you just go here to section, you create a section like that. There we go. You open that up, and it's going to look like this. Now you want to expand it all the way down, and then to create that, let's see, just go back to site. Yeah, make sure the section is as close to that mullion as possible, like this. Okay, now in the section, what you simply want to do is go to architecture, go to column, structural column. Let's pick out the plane, which is going to be reference plane A, click OK. And then you choose your column. In this case, let's just do like around 300 millimeter. Obviously, you would kind of pick out what works for your project, and then you're just gonna connect it like this. Go to the 3D view, there we go. And then let's do the same thing on the other side. So just site plan here. And you can we rotate this? Perhaps that's easiest. Yeah, perfect. And just place it like that. You open it up, and here we go. So again, you go to column, you go to slanted column, obviously, and then you just, let's see, is it on the reference plane? Where do we set the reference plane? Okay, let's set the reference plane to B, click OK. Okay, let's do that again now. Okay, so now you just go from this point to this point here. Perfect. You go to the 3D view just to make sure everything looks correct, and it does. So there we go. Now we have those kind of V columns on the kind of on the edges, and obviously you would just repeat that same thing on all sides. So there you go. That's how you create these kind of complicated structures inside of Revit. So if you want to get this project file, or if you want to get any of my other Revit project files, those are available on my Patreon page, which is going to be just in the description below this video, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.